flame working, because we work with a torch here. And a lot of people want to know the process of how it happens and how do you get that little hole in the bead. So we're going to cover this. It's not a long video. Hopefully you'll enjoy watching this. So, we start with this basic mandrel. That's actually just a stainless steel welding rod. Cut to appropriate lengths. We have a kiln wash. Dip this in the kiln wash and put a thin coat on the stainless steel rod. And I tap it down to make it smooth and even. And let it dry, preferably overnight, but you can flame dry it in the flame. If you dry it too fast, then it cracks. It's like clay when it comes to ceramics. I will show you, these are our basic rods that we use. They pre-make these. There's a big supplier in the United States. I think he's the biggest supplier there is. I buy from him, but they make these glass rods specifically for what I am doing. All kinds of colors, which we'll show you in a minute. The colors are phenomenal. I mean, it's never ending. Everybody says, you got too much glass. And I'm going, no, they keep coming up with new colors. And I just have to buy them. So. We have safety issues. Very important. I have my nifty-nifty little fire extinguisher stuff. I have safety glasses, much like welding glasses, only not quite as strong. The fan, the noise that you have to bear with me on, is an exhaust fan that takes the fumes out of the room, because when you burn glass, there's all kinds of metals and chemicals in the glass, so they have to be exhausted out. You could actually get pretty sick from this stuff, silver poisoning, mold poisoning, etc. So we have to do that. Noisy fan. We use oxygen from a item that's very similar to a medical concentrator. This is a little more powerful. It's been holding on to me here for probably, I think maybe 15 years. No problem with this one. I also have an oxygen tank that I can use if I need more power, meaning a hotter flame. I seldom use that. We have a kiln that we have to use to anneal our beads. I've been pre-making some beads. There's some beads in here now. They sit at 960 degrees for approximately 3 to 4 hours, and it could be even 5, depending on the type of glass. It's called the annealing process. It's this very slow cool down, and it tells the different colors of glass. You have to get along here for the rest of your life. It makes a very durable bead, so it won't crack. So now we're going to fire up the torch. This is my Jim Dandy torch that has never ever given me any problems, knock on wood. I love it. I can work borosilicate glass or soft glass with it. This is a flame working video. They call it flame working for obvious reasons. And I'm demonstrating how we can put a bead together for those that don't know. One of the tools that I have that a lot of people don't have because it was custom made for me is my warming rack here. Absolutely awesome. A friend custom made that for me. It's a blessing because you pre-warm the glass and the tips, and then you don't get shatters and breaks all over the table. I'm going to, this is the, it's all dry. I believe that's the dry one. I'm going to make sure that's the dry one. So we slowly heat this up in the flame. We're going to make an organic barrel shape bead. Basic shape of a barrel bead. I'm applying all kinds of colors here. This particular rod has all sorts of colors in it, and lots of silver. Now I'm going to shape this bead. This is my nifty dipty marver here that my husband made for me. No, he doesn't sell them. It's a one of a kind. It's just special. See, it's made with love. So now we're shaping the bead. And as it cools, it changes colors. And for the sake of the video here, you can see it's brown on this side, green on that side. I can change that by readjusting my oxygen and propane. I change the level of oxygen versus propane, and it can make a difference. I usually spend more time shaping my bead, but for the sake of the video, now it will have all sorts of different colors in it. You can see some. See the dark blue here. I can change that if I want by leaving it in the flame a longer time, bring it out. That's basically how we make a bead, using the flame and the torch. Now I'm going to take this bead over and I'm going to put it in the kiln and let it sit there for its prescribed amount of time. Now we have the bead sitting in the kiln, and I set the kiln to do its annealing cycle. It's all digital, which is really great. That means I don't have to watch it. And now you can see some of the rods that I have, the products it takes to make this glass, different shapes of mandrels up here on top to get different shapes of beads. Here's some frit that you can use to get all sorts of different colors and different types of beads. It's a lot of fun. It's never ending. There's glass. People keep coming up with combinations of rods and frits. And we have borosilicate glass here. So this is some of my glass rod stock that I have. I have borosilicate glass behind me. This is soft glass. Different types of soft glass are in different places labeled. You cannot mix them. Frits I have. We're going to show you some finished product over here now. And that'll be the basis of the video. So some of the product that we have here, the finished results, this is my nifty dipty little shot glass. That's my roadkill frog. Isn't he cute? He's loving. I can't get rid of him. I hold on to him. This one here is a little crab. It's a paperweight. And you can see down inside it. Now we can show you some of the beads. They're finished bead products, and I have borosilicate beads, I have silver beads. These are, I love making the barrel beads, you can tell. These are silvered organic beads. This is what it looks like after they come out of the kiln. The process after this, you have to soak them to soften the kiln wash, and then you have to take them off of the rod, usually with tools, and then Dremel the inside to clean the holes out in the bead to get the bead release out. So even though it's done in the kiln, doesn't mean it's totally done yet. There's still more work to do. And we have here, I'll bring them in to focus here. We have just some barrel beads, just because this is a neat little display my hubby made, so. I'm using it. But there you go on our little video. So we have some of the finished product here also. I love my little nifty horse. I have to give Kathy Johnson credit for this. Some more beads. Can't get enough. I have so many beads. I don't know what I'll ever do with them all. I really don't, but I just love making them. It's just fun. My husband says it keeps me out of the bars, but he's not too sure that's a financially good option.